Hot 104.1.
Let's go back to Erica Mena, of course, from Love & Hip Hop, New York. I want to ask you, how did you feel about when you found out she was marrying Bow Wow?
You know what? People think the show is real time. It isn't. Mm-hmm. I hadn't spoken to Erica in months. Mm-hmm. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like 6-7 months prior to me finding out about the Bow Wow situation. So, being totally honest, not even on no joke, I didn't care. Like, I had already moved on. I'm three girls removed from Erica. I've dated 3 or 4 chicks since I had even spoken to Erica. So,
yeah.
God bless her. Good luck. If it's real, then
if it's real, hold on.
No, I gotta preface my saying. I gotta preface my comments. I gotta keep it 100. I'm not gonna go up here and lie.
That's what. What does it look like to you? That's what I'm saying. Like,
it looks real.
It looks real.
I mean, she turned down. She left Love & Hip Hop and. I guess because she's in love, right? So there's something to be said for that.
What do you think about these girls that get into this life of reality TV? If there's any advice, I mean, you've managed some of them before. What advice can you give somebody right now? Because it could be girls that's like, no, I want that. I want to be in that right there on VH1.
See, this is the thing with the world now. I actually got a book coming out. The book is called I Just Want You to Win.
Okay. Yo! Hold on.
On the bridge.
Let's go. Hold on. We got to clap for that one.
That's genius.
I just want you to win.
Exactly. So, I mean, and it's basically detailing what's going on today.
Yeah.
Instagram versus Vogue, Cosmo, Elle. There's different types of modeling and all that. So with social media, people are able to create this thing. Reality TV is the pinnacle of what social media is.
Right.
Like, the girls who are on social media doing what they do are actually fighting for a reality spot, right? Yeah. That's ultimately what you're looking for. Just be careful that what you ask for, because you're doing something for your followers. When you do something for television, all your bones are going to come out the closet. So if you ain't proud of your past and you can't handle people coming for you and coming at your neck, then you might want to just think about what you're doing. Because when you put out your business to 50, 100,000 people, that's cool. But when you do it for 10 million people every Monday night, it's a big difference.
With these girls that were quote-unquote in the life, what was that like before reality TV, before social media? I just want to know real quick.
Those girls, and see, this is the thing. I don't want to come off and seem like I'm hating on nobody else, because I'm a part of this reality thing, and I ain't never going to deny that. But the reality of the reality is, the turn up is what makes you successful. Yeah. Like, the turn up is what gets people to pay you to come into these markets.
Right. Yeah.
Reality TV ain't always painted in the most positive light. And that's a shame, because there's a lot of people that do things that are not always so ratchet, right?
Yeah.
But you guys don't care about that. So in order for people, you might.
Because
y'all have, you've been
different.
Around.
No, I get it. I understand totally what you're saying.
But
it's
when
different.
You turn on the TV, like, let's be clear. Jhonni Blaze, most popular girl on Love & Hip Hop right now.
Right. Yeah.
There's no doubt about that. Yeah. You can't deny that her. But she's a turn-up queen.
Yeah.
Does she have any? And the thing about it is, she really can sing. She really was.
See, I wouldn't know
dope.
That.
You wouldn't know that, because unless you watch her on, unless you follow her life, then you don't know that. Because you follow her from 8 to 9 on Monday nights,
right,
and that's what you see, and that's who you pay to come in. That's what Erica was. Erica could have possibly been a model or something one day, but she chose the reality route. She was ratchet. She's never gonna get a cover girl ad when they Google her or look at her and see who she is. Mm-hmm. And I'm that guy now. I ain't gonna lie. I'm the Creep Squad guy now. So nobody remembers me from
Wait,
Bad Boy.
I have one question, because I have to go.
Okay. Hold on.
Here we go.
No, we just go back. So, I figured. So what happened in the bathroom, man? Let's keep it 100. You smashed or not smashed? I don't care about nothing else you're saying right now. Did you smash or not smash?
I did not smash.
Hey, Richie, stop it. Did you smash or not smash, man? What happened, man?
Me and Diamond are cool. And
I know you cool. Did you smash or not smash?
No, I didn't. I did not smash.
Jesus, man.
No, I didn't.
100?
Look, I'm not gonna lie to you.
On the Creep Squad, son? Chris? Chris? El Presidente? I'm saying, I'm not
kidding. Yo, this dude.
We going back to the crib.
We going back to the city.
Did you smash or not smash? Because it sounded like you were smashing in the bathroom.
Yo, that's that Love & Hip Hop. What you call it?
Oh, wait a minute. I thought it was 100.
It is 100. And we both made that mistake. We went in the bathroom, and I think when we left. It's up for debate now, right?
So it's up for the imagination.
But I'm gonna tell you what the truth is.
What's up?
But it's Love & Hip Hop's job to leave it up for the imagination. So I'm not mad at them. But I'm gonna tell the truth, and I did not have sex with Diamond Strawberry in the bathroom, contrary to what the world may think. And I wouldn't lie on my pee pee. Either way, good or bad, I don't like.
Would you? Would you though?
Would I still be Diamond Strawberry?
Yeah.
I'm actually in a relationship right now.
Retiring from the Crip Squad, look. I'm retiring.
I need to go to break on that one.